Hello, hi, this is Rakeshis. Welcome to my YouTube channel Agri Entomology Tutors. If you are watching my video for the first time, please subscribe the channel and click on the bell button. Today we can discuss about the origin of insects. Before knowing about the origin of insects, let's look into the classification of animals. The classification means the grouping of organisms or any animals based on some similar characteristics. Here the animals are grouped into vertebrates and invertebrates. And here the vertebrates having the backbone and the invertebrates does not having backbone. And the vertebrates are classified into reptiles, fishes, amphibians, mammals and birds. And here in case of the invertebrates, the protozoa, flatworms, annelids, echinoderms, arthropods, molluscs, coelenterates, all these will come. But here you can see the annelids having segmented body. For example, earthworms. And in case of the arthropods also having the segmented body with jointed limbs and hard external skeleton called exoskeleton. Here you can notice the origin of arthropods from annelid members. And again, arthropod consisting of the arachnids, crustaceans, insects, myriapods. In these myriapods, centipedes and millipedes will come. In upcoming videos, we will learn all about the arachnids, crustacea, insects and centipedes and millipedes. Let's know about the insect, how to identify the insect. Here you can see the picture. The body is divided into three regions. You can see the head and the thorax consisting of three segments and the abdominal part. Here you can see the body is divided into three regions. And the insect consisting of three pair of legs, three pair of jointed legs, one pair, two pair, three pairs, consisting of three pair of legs and a pair of antenna. Here you can see the antenna, the sensory structures and two pair of wings. You can notice two pair of wings on insect thoracic part. Then what is insect? Insects are the tracheated arthropods having exoskeleton, three pair of legs, two pair of wings, one pair of antenna and the body divided into head, thorax and abdomen. The Charles Darwin in his theory he says that it is not the strongest of the species that survives, nor the most intelligent that survives. It is the one that is most adaptable to the change. This definition mainly holds good for the insects. Darwin's in his theory of evolution by natural selection, he gave the five basic premises which mainly well fits or well suited for the insects. Those are natality, variability, survivorship, heritability, and time. Let's look into all those premises one by one. First one is natality. Here the survive and reproduce. Many more individuals are born in each generation than they will survive and reproduce. Second one is variability. Here the variation created among the individual for certain characteristics. The individuals, next one is survivorship. Here the variability created for a certain characteristics which may be helps for better chance of surviving and reproducing than the individuals with other characteristics. The fourth one is heritability. Due to the differential reproduction, some of the characters which will heritable from one generation to the another generation of the insects is called as heritability. And the last one, fifth one, is time. this enormous lifespan of time which is available for the insect because of their less time to take completion of one generation, which leads to the gradual change and which finally leads to the evolution of the insects. When we look into this pie chart, which represents the different organisms and their shares in the world, here the insects takes a lion's share of 10 lakh species in the world, and the fishes 19,000, and the flowering plants 2,90,000, and the mammals 4,000, Columbola 6,000, and all. Here you can see the graphical representation of the evolution of different organisms on the earth. Here you can see the molluscans and the octopus, the spiders, centipedes, millipedes, insects, and finally the mammals, birds are here. The insects are originated in the Devonian period of Paleozoic era. And here you can notice some of the dotted lines are here. This is the fossil insects or fossil organisms species which are not detected as because of their the linking is missed here. The some of the fossil fuels are available to know about the history of these insects or organisms, but the some links are missed to connect all these organisms of fossils. As the evolution begins, the insects are most adaptable, hence here the evolution begins, and the insects occupy the more number of species on the earth. Here you can see the echinoderms, there is almost similar, there is no evolution, but here you can see the insects, the evolution is more, and in case of the molluscans also little bit of evolution is there. But in case of the centipedes as well as millipedes also, the origin of centipedes begins before the origin of the insects, and the evolution is a little bit less as in case of the centipedes and millipedes. But in case of the insects, they are most adaptable to that particular environment in the olden days, and they have become more evolutionized. As I already told, the insects are originated in Devonian period of Paleozoic era in 350 to 500 million years ago. Here the Carboniferous period is there, that is 345 million year ago. The first great radiation of insects will happen. Here the winged insects can be seen here. In case in Carboniferous period, the winged insects will appear. And in case of the Cretaceous period, 135 million year ago, the second great radiation of insects happened. Here the wing flexion mechanism will arises. In case of the tertiary, the 63 million year ago, the dominance of the land by the mammals, birds and insects can be seen. And in Quaternary, 2 million year ago, the first Homo sapien or first Homo species will appear on the earth. Origin of primitive insects occurred in Devonian period of Paleozoic era, which was about 350 to 500 million year ago, and the development of winged insects occur in Upper Carboniferous period. You see here the development of winged insects occur in Upper Carboniferous period, and the development of wing flexion mechanism seen in middle of the Carboniferous period. And the last one is the metamorphosis. The metamorphosis occurred in the lower carboniferous period. We can see the metamorphosis. The earliest known fossil insect is the Rhynchella precursor. This Rhynchella precursor, which is in Collambolan, identified in or discovered in Scotland by the scientist called Hirston Mowlick in 1926. This is one of the important question for your JRF exam. And another important question is the oldest fossil of pterygoids are. One belongs to the Odonaton and another one is Homopteran. This Odonaton is Erasipteran lariski and the Homopteran is the Protoprosol Strileni. Here you can see the Collambolan Rhynchella precursor identified in Scotland in 1926 by Hirston Mowlick. And the Carboniferous period, that period is called as the Age of Cockroaches, and the Devonian period is called as Age of Sharks. One of the important question for your JRF and other exams is the which organisms are what is the connecting link between the annelid and arthropod. The answer is the velvet worms. Velvet worms, peripatus species, or walking worms, Onychophora. Here you can see the picture of the velvet worms or Onychophora or peripatus species. Here one of the diagram. Here you can see the body is divided into segmented, or the body is segmented and consisting of the trunk appendages are the legs and eye, antenna. These organisms acts as a connecting link between the annelids and arthropods. Thank you for watching the video. Please like, share and subscribe the channel. And then in next video onwards, we can directly start with the morphology of insects. Thank you very much.